Respiratory distress in children is caused by either upper or lower airway diseases. Upper airway obstruction is recognized by the presence of stridor, a high-pitched sound often audible without a stethoscope, mainly on inspiration, but can also be heard on expiration. Aspiration of a foreign body, especially frequent in the 1 to 3 age group, must be ruled out. A history of aspiration may be offered by the patient or family. Remember to get imaging. While the foreign body may be lucent, look for signs of hyperinflation. Another serious cause of upper airway obstruction is viral laryngotracheal bronchitis, or croup. Patients with croup have a stridor and usually have a cough that sounds like a seal bark. A dose of systemic corticosteroid will alleviate the obstruction for the course of the illness, but nebulized epinephrine may sometimes be necessary to reduce the edema quickly to relieve the acute respiratory distress. A rare but severe complication of croup is bacterial tracheitis. Lower airway obstruction presents with shortness of breath, a prolonged expiratory phase, wheezing, and accessory muscle use. In children over 2 years old, viral-induced asthma is the most common cause for this presentation. Inhaled bronchodilators are used for symptomatic relief, but corticosteroids are essential to settle the lower airway inflammation. Bronchiolitis is caused by a viral infection in infants less than 12 months of age, and while it may present very similarly to asthma, it does not respond to bronchodilators or corticosteroids. Recommended management includes supportive care such as intravenous hydration if the infant is too distressed to feed, oxygen supplementation if the oxygen saturation is below 90%, and ventilatory support for impending respiratory failure. Pediatric pneumonia often presents after symptoms of viral upper respiratory infections, but with fast breathing and lung crackles. Lung radiography confirms the diagnosis, and the pattern of infiltrate or consolidation may guide antibiotic selection.